Hello learners, welcome to NIOS. My name is Vinita Dhawan. Today we will study about the selection and coordination of material related to work education in primary classes. First of all, a brief introduction to work education. What is work education? A purposive and meaningful manual work result in the good and services useful to the society. Another point we can include in work education, essential life skills are developed in work education. Another one, activities based on natural, physical, human resource, social and economic background of the society. And what another points we can include in work education? It establishes coordination between hand and brain. It is based on the principle of learning by doing. It nurtures self-confidence and self-reliance in children. So it was all about work education. Now, our today topic is selection and coordination of material in work education. We'll discuss about these two points. First, we'll discuss about the selection of material. Then we'll discuss about the coordination of material. First of all, we'll talk about the selection of material. Selection of material, what is selection of material? Selection of material means what kind of material we will select for the work education activities. In this, we can include the material which is easily available in home. We can select that material. If the material is not easily available at home, so we can go for the material which is easily available in neighborhood and society. And in the last, we can say which is material which is easily available in the market and student can afford to buy it. Means we can select the material for work education from these three: at home, neighborhood and society, and if the student can buy it from the market. Now, how to collect these materials? How to collect this material includes the three units in this. The first one is easily available material from nature. The second one is waste material. And the third one is low cost material. So when we come to the collection of the material, we can take the material from these three resources. The first is easily available material from nature. The second is waste material. And the third one is low cost material. Now we'll discuss about these three one by one. First, we will talk about the easily available material from the nature, or we can say this, the natural material. What is a natural material? First of all, we should know what is a natural material. A natural material is any product or physical matter that come from the plant, animal or the ground. It can be biotic. Biotic means wood, natural fiber, cotton, jute, silk. It is included in the biotic. And this another one is inorganic material. In inorganic material, we can include stone, gems, native material, etc. Now, what material is exactly which is available from the nature? In this, what we can include is plant. We can have plant, seeds, fruits, tree stem, tree bark, bamboo, jute, hard shell of coconut, the brown one, leaves, sand, oil, fiber, stone, water, glue, neem, etc. These are the easily available material from the nature. We can use this material for the work education activities. Now the second one is waste material. Waste material, first of all, we should know what is the waste material. Waste are the unwanted or unusable material. Waste is a substance which is discarded after primary use, or it is worthless, defective and of no use. This is the waste material. Now, we should come to know what is exactly included in the waste material. In the waste material for which we can perform our activities, like empty boxes, it comes under waste material. Empty boxes, after that feather, wooden and hardboard boxes. This comes under waste material, and another things, used foam, sponge, shoe boxes, rags, old blankets which is torn, old mats which is of no use, old newspaper which we used to collect it at our homes, old magazines, used plastic bags, lid of soft drink bottle, used plastic cups. Another points we can include in this, lid of toothpaste, thin wire, thick wire, used pen, old blade, old postcard, old stamp, old envelope, old greeting cards, thread, button, chain, cycle tube, ice cream spoons, egg peel, and old broom. These all comes under the waste material. Now, if we'll talk about this waste material, if we talk about if we talk about the empty boxes, I have discussed it. The first point, empty boxes. What we can prepare with the empty boxes under work education? We can prepare the photo frame with the empty boxes. We have in our houses empty boxes. Cardboard tray we can prepare with the empty boxes. A dog house we can prepare with the empty boxes. And the traffic light, which traffic light is given as a project to the children in the primary classes. So we can use the empty boxes to prepare to make that traffic light. And another one, what we can prepare with the empty boxes, aquarium. Aquarium in which we show the fishes. Fish, that aquarium can be prepared with the help of empty boxes. We can cover the box with a clean paper, or we can cover them nicely. We can cover the empty box and then we can hang the fishes inside it. That will be the aquarium for us. Another one, waste material, we can say ice cream sticks. What we can prepare with the ice cream sticks? We can prepare the wall hanging, craft work we can do with the ice cream sticks. We can prepare the, we can make the pen holder with the ice cream sticks. And another one, we can prepare the baskets with ice cream sticks. A small basket we can prepare. Small baskets include, we can join the ice cream sticks one by one. We can paste one by one, and then we can prepare the basket, and we can give any shape to that, rhombus or square or rectangle, any shape we can give to that. Another decorative items we can prepare with the ice cream sticks, that is the peacock we can prepare. And on the wall hanging also, we can use the ice cream sticks. We can join the sticks and then we can paste the flowers and other decorative material to make it more beautiful. So these were the items which we can prepare with the ice cream sticks. Another one in the waste material, we include the old newspapers. With the old newspaper, what we can do in the underwork education? Paper bags we can prepare. Paper bag we carry. Paper in paper bag, what the student can put, they can put their assignments and another spare sheets we can put in the paper bag. So a nice, a beautiful paper bag can be prepared with the old newspapers. We can prepare the basket with the old newspapers. We can prepare the photo frame, a very beautiful photo frame with the help of old newspapers. We can prepare, like we have prepared the basket, the same way we can prepare the dustbin with the help of old newspapers. Now the next under waste material, we can say the matchsticks. If you talk about the matchsticks, the both the things are useful. Both means the match box and the matchsticks, both are useful. What we can prepare with the matchsticks and match boxes? Match home can be prepared with the help of match boxes. Dump truck. Dump truck means it is like a toy truck we can give to the kids. And match sofa box. So matchbox sofa. Matchbox sofa means we can cover the matchboxes nicely with colored paper, and then we can create sofas and we can create a drawing room scene with the help of matchboxes. And another one, we can prepare jewelry boxes with the help of matchboxes. And the very important one is the scenery. We can prepare the scenery with the help of matchsticks. Very beautiful scenery we can create with the help of matchsticks. So these all are the waste material which we can use for our activities. Another one under work education, another one under waste material, we can say the plastic cup, used plastic cups. How they can be used? They can be used to prepare the doll house, flower pot, butterfly, snowman, penguin, flowers, and many other decorative items we can prepare with the plastic cups. We can give any shape to those plastic cups. Like if you talk about the butterfly, then we can put that plastic cup down and we can create the wings of the butterfly, and then we can put the nose and eyes, and we can create a very beautiful butterfly with that. And if you talk about the flowers, we can cut that plastic cup from the sides, all the sides, and we can prepare the beautiful flowers after coloring them. So these things we can prepare with the plastic cups. And what we can do with the used pens under waste material? In the waste material, we have used pen, and what we can make with the used pens? Pen stand we can prepare. In how we will prepare the pen stand, we can join the all the used pens. We can join, we can paste means used pens one another, and then we can prepare the pen stand. Chandelier we can prepare with the used pens. Table lamp we can prepare. We can paste them together. Then we can create this pen stand and table lamp, etc. Greeting cards, this also comes under waste material. We have so many greeting cards of the various festivals, birthday cards we can say. So what we can prepare with the greeting cards? Gift boxes we can create with the help of greeting cards, and with the help of old greeting cards, used greeting cards, we can make another new greeting card for some occasion. Now the third one, we can say the low cost material. We have talked about the two things already. We have talked about the two things, that is natural material, and the third one is the low cost material. We have talked about the natural material and we have talked about the waste material. Now the third point is low cost material. Now what is this low cost material? Low cost material is the material which are available cheaply and developed by locally available resource and expedite the process of learning in the classroom. Now what comes under the low cost material? Low cost material includes scissor, glue, knife, candle, scale, cloth, screw, tape, inch tape, wooden pieces, brush, color, different kinds of paper, resin, rubber, etc. These all comes under the low cost material. Now we should know what are the advantages of this low cost material. It cheapens, very cheap it is, low cost material. No fear of loss in this low cost of material. This proper use of low cost material. Maintenance and repair, relevance of the curriculum. And another point we can include, the higher school content we can cover with the low cost material. Self-reliance, we can make it easily available. Related to the real life, these all the material are related to the real life. These are economic, we can already said about it, cheap it is, very economic it is. It is helpful for the teacher and it gives the strength. Now, what we have to do with the collected material? We have already done about the selection of the material. Now, we talk about the coordination of that material. What we will do, how we will coordinate that material? We have already selected that material. Now, first of all, we will prepare the list of the material. Whatever the students have brought in the classroom, we will prepare one list. Then what we will do after that? Write detail which object is collected and by whom. The teacher will write the detail of the material, and she or he will write also ki which object is collected and by whom it is collected. The name of the person, the name of the child will be written in front of that material. The another thing which we will do, honor the child who bring material which is not easily available. We should honor that child who bring the material which is not easily available, and with what we should honor him or her? Amusing material of the week. The child feel encouraged with this and he or she will try to again bring that material in the classroom. Now we'll talk about the benefits of selection and collection of material. We have already studied about the selection of the material and collection of the material. We should know what are the benefits, why we select the material, why we collect the material, is there any benefit of it? Yes, if we say, what are the benefits of selection and collection of material? In this first point we can include, it develop the positive attitude among the children. A very positive attitude is among the children when they collect the material themselves. They feel very good, yes, this material is collected by me. So it gives them encouragement to collect the material again and again. So it is the point that it develops the positive attitude among the children. Now, if we talk about the second point, it makes the student scientific. When the student collect the material himself or herself, then it makes them scientific. The third one is keeping things in an organized way. They learn to keep the things in an organized way. When the students select the material or collect the material, they put them at one place, or we can say they put them in an organized way. They learn about it. So in this point, we have included the keeping thing in an organized way. It is the benefit of selection and collection of material. If the child herself select that material or collect that material. So another point we can include, it develop the ability to observe the environment of the surrounding. When we send our children to collect the material or to select the material in his or her surroundings, so what ability they develop? They develop the ability to observe the things, to observe the environment, to observe their surroundings. So this ability is developed. So they feel very good, they feel encouraged, they are motivated. Yes, this material is collected by me. So we should send the children to select the material or to collect the material from various places. It gives them a very good experience. So these were the benefits of the selection and collection of material. Now if we talk about the coordination of material. Coordination of material, we have already done the selection of material till here. Now, it is also important to coordinate that material. What is the meaning of coordination? Coordination means to bring together that material. Means what item we will prepare. We have already collected the material. Now, what item will be prepared? How we will coordinate all that material? So, it is the coordination of material. Or in other words, we can say how to use the collected material. In a coordination of material, we can say how to use that collected material. What we can do as a teacher, we can ask the students which object they would like to make from the collected material. We have seen that many students have brought the material from their surroundings and from their neighborhood. So we can ask the students, so what kind of object, what object they will like to prepare. So teacher can give many options to them, then they can select, they can finalize that this material will be prepared by them, this item will be prepared by them. So another point we can include in this, and under the coordination of material, discuss the source of material and its use. If we have finalized what item we are going to prepare, so we can discuss the source of that. If we need it in more number, so we can discuss the source of material. If something is finalized, so we need it in a large quantity. If we need it in a large quantity, we can discuss with them what is the source of material and what is the use of that item if we'll prepare that item. So it comes under the coordination of material. The another one we can include is many things that can be made from the same material. A teacher can tell them that many things can be made from the same material. If you are using one material for one activity or for any one item, the same material can be used to prepare the another item. So these were the points under the coordination of material. Now if we say we talk about the selection, and we have already talked about the selection and collection coordination of material under the work education. In the selection of material, we have selected the material from three places. We have included the natural material, we have included the waste material, and we have included the low cost material. Each three has different importance. If we talk about the natural material, the natural material is available from the nature, easily available from the nature. The another one is waste material. Waste material we can take from our homes or in the neighborhood, which is of no use or discarded. We have already talked about it. So that was under the waste material. And the third one we have studied is low cost material. Low cost material means which are easily available, like scissors, knife, inchi tape, these things we have included in the low cost material. After that, we have studied about the coordination of material. First, we have selected the material, then we have to coordinate that material. And for the coordination, the teacher plays an important role. She or he will tell to the students what item we can prepare with your collected material. And if all are agree, then one item can be prepared under work education with that material. So students, today we have started about the selection and coordination of material under work education. Thank you.